So it's time for me to leave Norway, heading back to Sweden. So this is a travel day, probably a part of tomorrow is a travel day as well. So I will share some views from the way home, and hopefully something interesting is at the end. So stick with me. It didn't take long before I spotted some kestrels, and it looks like they're the young ones. So I was hang out here for a while and see if I can get any good shots. This must be one of the best places to grow up on as a kestrel. Look at those views, look at those fields. Must be heaven. So how much I want to stay, I have to go. But I have noticed this position because I think this is a nesting ground, so I'll be back next year probably. So let's carry on. So I've reached my destination for the evening, Flatøret in the middle part of Sweden. And here I will walk around, look around, see if I can see anything before it's bedtime. Hopefully I see some birds that are living up here in the mountain area. But there's no promise, as you know, in one life. Thank you. Yeah, so that was a nice but unexpected experience. I didn't anticipate to see a female capercaillie walking across the road. And furthermore, staying close to the road, they usually go very fast into hiding. But this one was quite curious about me and my beautiful camper van. Bird activity up here on the mountain has been very slow, much due to the fact that there is a quite strong wind, and of course that is raining. So all the small birds, when they move, they keep close to the ground. So this ends travel day number one. It's time for me to go to bed, and I'll see you tomorrow. So, good morning to you. It's been a good night's rest, at least for me. Some rain, some thunder, and this morning's walk didn't produce any pictures at all. So, it's time to head south. The first stop will be, the first planned stop will be the highest waterfall in Sweden. Could be interesting. Well, so I finally made it to Njupeskär in Fuglefjellet National Park, and I've showed it's still a couple of kilometers to go, but unfortunately the shortest route is closed due to repairs, so it's going to be a bit more time consuming than I expected. Now I have some Siberian jays right to the right. Should I go that way, or should I go this way? Decisions. Well, the Siberian jay is quite friendly to us people, as long as we have a little bit of food with us. I took a bit of my snack here, sausage actually, and put on the trees. So they have something to eat, or rather they stash it. So they got some stash and I got some photos. It's a win-win situation. Well, as you expected, I'm not only here for the waterfall. There are often some birds here. I've seen two of them, the white throated dipper and the Siberian jay. There are more. Let's hope I can find them as well. So let's carry on. I don't know if you can hear the thunder in the background, but I think that's my cue to exit this waterfall and head back to the car and see if it starts raining or not. Well, I can sense the first driplets from a coming rain. Hopefully not. Of course I didn't bring any rain clothes. I still got about 2 kilometers to the car. And there was the thunder, did you hear that? Yeah, push on. I think that will wrap up this episode, this travel photo episode. Traveling from A to B, taking pictures along the way. It has been nice showing you some of the things I see when I'm out traveling, and I hope you enjoyed watching. So if you do, please give it a thumbs up, subscribe, write a comment. All of those three is very appreciated. You should know that. I got still several hundred kilometers to my next stop, so if I get lucky there, that will be a separate episode. So until next time, bye for now. Well, I made it back to the car, and just in time when the rain started to increase and lightning started to come real close. So now I'm just sitting here, enjoying my cup of coffee, watching the rain outside. Quite cozy, actually.